Currently, there are different kind of indications for the realization of percutaneous ablation. Mostly we can do palliative treatment for patients who are in pain, but also we can go for complete ablation in patients which present with some tumor that we need curative ablation, for example, some small benign lesions or even some metastases in oligometastatic patients. We have different kind of patients. The patients who have already been treated by radiotherapy and cannot be treated anymore. There are patients that are sent directly to us, for example, the benign lesions such as osteoidosteoma, for example, they go directly to the interventional radiologist. And for the metastatic patient, mostly the palliative indication, we mostly have patients which are unfit for surgery or which might not benefit from these techniques, or patients who are reluctant to go for radiotherapy or surgery.
The indications for percutaneous cementoplasty include pain palliation, structural support and bone consolidation after local tumor control therapies, and prophylactic performance in terms of preventing and impeding pathologic fracture. The oncology community is trying to solve the pain cancer issue, and up until now, the vast majority of patients are undertreated. As far as clinical evidence is concerned, we have a moderate number of single-center observational studies and a huge number of case reports illustrating safety and efficacy of the technique. What we really need is biomechanical evaluation of the cement injection or of the hybrid techniques combining cement with metallic instrumentation. We need to figure out which is the ideal combination in terms of lesion, location and technique, the combination that will provide us the unique characteristics for structural support and pain reduction.
Osteosynthesis is a new option for interventional radiologists. We can offer it for bone cancer patients suffering from osteolytic metastases. The indication for cementoplasty and osteosynthesis are quite similar. Basically, we prefer cementoplasty for vertebra to palliate vertebral fracture or for consolidation of osteolytic metastases located in the vertebra because of the mechanical property of the cement that is appropriate in this location because the stress are in compression. For osteosynthesis, it's quite the same indication, but it is more appropriate in the pelvis because of the stress that occur in the pelvis location. It could be a bending, shearing stresses. So here we prefer osteosynthesis. And mainly osteosynthesis is associated with a cement consolidation in this location.
We can combine the use of percutaneous ablation with some consolidation techniques such as cementoplasty or percutaneous synthesis, usually in the same session. So it's only performed by the interventional radiologist. But we have also cases where we need the help of other specialties. So in some selected cases, you can combine it with surgery. And there are also cases where you have to treat the patient after radiotherapy, or radiotherapy might help you to increase the chance of a complete treatment after percutaneous ablation. And there are plenty of works to do in that field. If you're a trained interventional radiologist, I think that you can do this kind of procedure in bone. There is no reason not to do it. However, you have to be trained a little bit because there are some specificities related to bone, such as the risk of fracture after ablation and also the proximity of nerves. So you have to be able to perform thermal insulation, for example. And you need precise image guidance to perform this procedure. So if you have all that, there is no reason not to do it. You just have to be a little bit trained. We'll be right back.